Okay, part four, here we go.
A couple of little things. We're gonna start with a thinner halter so you understand that they can learn to push. And this is called opposition reflex, and that's what he's learned to do. He just pushes himself around, he pushes on the rope and on the bit and everything. And then we're gonna teach him a couple of little boundaries. We're gonna teach him when to be parallel, when to be perpendicular. So right now, I want him to be perpendicular, but...
How does the horse know that? How does the horse know you want him to be perpendicular? See, a horse doesn't care what you want. He'll trade you 5 pounds of wants for 10 pounds of wishes. It doesn't matter. The horse, how does the horse know? You have to make the right answer easy and show the horse. Parelli, kind of like he did with the bag, is I'll just keep hitting you harder and harder until you do something I want. Well, here, I'll just keep shaking this damn rope and hitting you in the face with a metal buckle until I get the answer. I won't show you the answer. I won't help you get there. I will just keep hitting you until you guess at it, and then I'll stop.
See, now he wants lunch. But I want him to back up. He's going, but I don't back up. I go, oh, you can back up. Now, let's see. I'll bet he's going to lick his lips like crazy right now. You ready?
No shit. You just hit him and stressed him out. His tail is crazy. He's rearing. Of course he's going to lick his lips. But Rick, if he can predict that, it must mean that he knows. Anytime you stop putting pressure on a damn horse and you stress him out, he'll lick his damn lips, people.
He's looking over here like, what in the world? Who changed all the rules to my game? Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Alrighty.
Oh, he just licked his lips. Wow. Shocking.
What
he understood.
In the world? Who
Watch
changed
it close.
All the rules to my
game? Oh, wow. He just licked his lips. Man, he just understood. That was a great lesson. Man, he picked. That horse is smart and that trainer is smart. Come on, people.
Game. Okay. Yeah. Alrighty. So the idea is that we've got to be able to. There's times when we want him parallel looking at us or perpendicular looking at us, and then there's other times we want him parallel, all right? And then, of course, the real seeker is going to, can we get him to be, to go to the right and to the left? All right, so we're going to bring him in now. There we go. Come here.
Notice the active tail. That tail is active because he's unsure, he's confused, he's frustrated. He doesn't know what the right answer is. He's been ambushed with a bag and a buckle to the face. And he hasn't learned, but Ricky licked his lips. He did learn. Okay, well, he's still freaking nervous. And his tail is active, and he's unsure, and he's confused. And that's okay, because horses get confused before they learn, and they resist, and I get all that. But call it what it is.
Tobe. Is it Toby or Keith?
Toby.
Okay.
I don't know that he likes music or not. We haven't done that therapy yet.
All right, so now you see how here I'm just... Now he doesn't want to come on in here.
Right.
So now what I'm going to do is watch my hands. The moment that he, and I'm leaning back here. Remember, I'm leaning way back.
Right.
The moment that he comes forward, I'm going to open up. So what we got to do is teach him how to get relief. There we go.
He didn't want him touching his hand because he didn't know. He's a little gun shy of this guy. Now, again, I'm not saying Parelli's a bad, mean, bad man. I just don't agree with his training techniques on a couple things. He gets results. Just because you get results does not mean it's good for the horse. That horse is flinching now and is a little nervous. But you got to give credit where credit is due. This guy who picked the horse because he was cute, who wanted a horse that he could train, who wanted a horse that he's never trained a horse for, he caused all this because he taught the horse to ignore humans, to ignore direction. He hasn't taught the horse to give to pressure. Hasn't taught the horse how to yield his hindquarters or his front end. Hasn't taught the horse how to come in and back up, how to lunge. He hasn't taught the horse anything except he's taught him how to be pushy and how to ignore humans. And that's why I say when people want to get feelings and they want to train a young horse because it makes them feel good, they set the horse up to punish and get pain when other people have to fix what they screwed up.
And this little thin halter again is going to be a lot more effective. And of course, now we got to give him the affection.
Yep.
All right. Now that he's up close, here can be the challenging part. So I'm going to take my fingers and I'm going to play a little game with him. And the game is you back up if you want relief. You see, I'm just taking my fingers on those. There's nerves
right there. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm just going to, hang in here until I got 1 foot to move and say, that's good. So when I'm in close, I need some strategies. Okay, because what he's done is the two of you have...
See, the horse doesn't even know how to back up or what the cue is, and you've already beat him in the face with a buckle. I don't like that technique. I'm not saying it's the worst technique in the world. I just don't like it. I'm not even saying it doesn't get results. But you know what? You can teach a horse freaking dance if you stick a freaking lightning rod up his ass and shock him to death. He'll dance. He might die, but he'll dance. So just because you get the results you want does not mean it's good for the horse.
We've gotten into this.
Right.
This is how we operate.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Too close. Yeah.
Yeah. And you know, like a lot of times a policeman will get a hold of a, they used to remember they say, you call it collaring.
Right.
You collar a bad guy, yeah. Right? It'd grab him by the collar. All right. So, but now what we need to do is just do that and ask you to back up. Now I'm going to give you the rope and see if you can just stop softly, wiggle a little bit. And you got to have intention. You got to have some willpower. Okay. Softly, softly, softly. And that's enough. All right. You see there?
Yeah.
So
did Parelli's technique work? Yes. Did he get results? Yes. Did the horse learn? Yes. He learned how to avoid pain of this, knowing it was going to hurt if I didn't back up. Is that the best way to teach him? Hey, to each his own.
He's got to learn some things.
Unfortunately, this guy is going to leave and thinks this is the only way I can back up a horse. He will never get rid of this technique, and his dying day will be, nope, the only way to get a horse to back up is like Parelli said, you got to shake that buckle until he learns.
What we're going to have is some new habits here. Okay, so let's try it again right here. Soft, 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 start soft, and then you can go firm.
Okay.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad he corrected him. Start soft and go firm. At least he corrected him. Because again, what did I just say? This guy for the rest of his life will be shaking, thinking it's the only way, and that's exactly what he did. He immediately started shaking. I'm glad Parelli said, whoa, soft, and then go firm. Good.
All right, start soft.
No, damn, dude, that was soft?
And let the rope slide as he backs up. No matter.
See, this guy has no feeling. He has no timing and no feel. He doesn't know what soft is. He said start soft, and he yanked that. He hit him with the buckle. Bam.
Just wiggle. Just put some rhythm. And let the rope slide as he backs up. No, now go faster, now faster, 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 bigger, stronger, faster. Come on, wiggle it more. All right, wiggle. There. Feel him go back?
Yep.
Now let him stay there. Give him even more rope.
Okay.
Okay. So now what you could do to...
This guy doesn't know about release. But the fact that he was hanging on the halter for the first 10 minutes of the video tells me he has no idea about pressure and release. That should have been the first thing he should have learned. And he doesn't know it. But he's going to train a horse. But Ricky loves the horse and he feeds him and he gave him an acre. And he sees him every morning when he goes to work and every night when he goes back. And he loves him. A horse doesn't care if you love him. They care what you do. Give him a good quality of life and quit being a selfish. You just want some horse that waits for you. So when you go and feed him, you feel good because the horse is waiting because he's hungry. And then you feed him in the morning and he's waiting and you feel good because he has no choice. Because you've taken away his ability to be a horse and you've made him to where he has to be dependent on you so you feel good.
I'm going to put a different rope on. What you can do now is learn the mechanics of how to get the rope to deliver the message. All right, it's real simple. We're gonna do that. This
horse is like shit. One buckle wasn't enough to beat the hell out of me. Now you're putting two on. Hell, horse, quick, lick your lips so you get it. Two buckles are worse than one.
Rope is 12 foot long that you've got, and I'm putting on a.
Oh look, he licked his lips. Do you see that? Damn, I'm a freaking horse whisperer.
Right?
Watch
it's
this.
Real simple.
Two buckles better than one. Watch a horse lick his lips.
This rope is 12 foot long that you've got, and I'm putting.
Whoa,
on a
he licked his lips. He must be learning. He understood. Jesus Christ, I'm a horse whisperer and I didn't even know it.
22 feet, okay.
So now, what I want you to do is hang on to just the end here, the very end of this. Let me have this back. Step back here just a little bit. Now, I want you to find something out here that if you, right there, if you wiggle just your wrist, see what happens. Nothing much, huh?
Right.
Stop your wrist, now turn your hand sideways, okay? And now what I want you to do is bend your elbow. Turn your hand sideways and all elbow. See how much more that does?
Yeah.
Okay, now straighten your elbow and swing your whole arm. Swing, 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 swing. Your whole arm. Don't bend your elbow. Swing your whole arm, swing your whole arm, swing your whole arm. Keep your elbow straight, keep your elbow straight. Keep your elbow straight, your elbow's bending.
Okay,
so you've got a lot more. That kind of bothers him, doesn't it?
Right, yeah.
Yeah, hey man, he was really learning. Hell, I bet he licks his lips. After his tail stops shaking, his head goes down, and they stop swinging and hitting him, I bet he licks his lips. Ready?
See, let me try this again. Elbow's got to be
absolutely straight. They didn't show him
licking
his lips, damn
it. All...
I bet he licked his lips.
Wait, no, don't bend your elbow.
Okay.
All the way across and all the way out here. Okay, now hold on to it just right here. Put your hand on one hand. So right now. Ready?
Okay.
Now just practice the whole arm. Feel that? Holy smokes. There, stop. Look at that horse. He's going, how did he do that from way? Look how far we are.
Right, yeah.
This is what we've got to do. See, horses know how to judge safety by distance and approach. So at first, they don't let humans or any predators get near. Like, if we're this close, you go, he could get me. So horses would always stay a mile away or, something like that. But once they get familiar to things, then they go, he can't make me do anything from here.
But he can.
Okay, now you can, all right?
Okay, and that little technique, and I got a lot of heat because I tell people I throw rocks at my horses sometimes. I never aim for their head. I aim for their big butts. But a horse has to know that you can back up what you're doing at a distance. If you try to correct a horse and he's out in pasture 2 acres away and you start yelling at him and telling him to back up and come and you better stop and you better... A horse will look at you and be like, you can't touch me from there. So unless a horse knows you can reach out and touch him and put pressure, they tend to ignore you. And that's kind of what he's saying here. The old timers would take a BB gun and shoot a horse in the butt if they turn their butt on him. And then the horse would figure out, hey, don't turn your butt on me. Now to me, if you need a BB gun to get a horse to turn his butt, he's too damn far to even worry about anyway. But again, there's just some people that just hate if a horse turns their butt to you. They take it as an immediate insult, and they just want to go crazy on a horse.
So now we've got a little longer rope. You're going to find out you can have even more leverage. We're going to find this out, okay? So now he's perpendicular, right?
Yeah.
So now I'm going to push him over here, parallel. You hang on so it doesn't. There we go. You get it, go. Out of here. You need to go away, Jose. That's it. Hey.
Watch his tail, watch his head, watch his ears. All the horse is telling him, I'm getting pressure. What do you want? What's the right answer? The horse is trying to figure out what to do.
Hang tight. Don't let him come to you. Don't let him step over it. There we go. If he can. Now hang on because he's gonna hit it. All right. So again, let him go. That's all right. There we go. And now hang on. Just hold. Wait for the, change your hands. That's a better position for that. I thought he said he didn't lunge.
Well, he doesn't lunge with me. He lunges with you.
Well, he will. No, he will.
He will. Okay.
He will, because just like he did the backup. Now, just kind of relax now. Now, there you go. Now, reel him in. Bring him in. Now just let the rope.
He's looping this damn rope again, because he doesn't learn. He hasn't. When people want to loop the rope, I tell them to go ahead and loop it, and then I'll just grab that rope and go, you got it looped? You think you got a good grip? And I'll rip it through their freaking hands. They'll be like, ow. And I go, I'm not a horse. Can you imagine if a 1,200-pound horse did that? Or I'll chase a horse. I go, okay, you think you got him? All right, I'm going to chase a horse, and I'll make the horse rip it out of their hands. Rick, that's just mean. You're going to get some. Hey, you know what? Sometimes hard lessons are the best lessons, and they're remembered the best.
Rope go on the ground. There you go. Reel him in. Bring him in. And now what we're going to do, we're going to say, good boy, good job, now come on back. We don't want him running away from us. Okay, come on, all the way, bring him in. Hang in there, hang tight, and just hold. Now don't use.
Notice the horse went to the person putting pressure, the horse went to him instead of the owner. The horse is looking for release. He doesn't want to piss off this guy, so he's going to him.
Use rhythm. Just hold. Just wait. I've never seen it take longer than 2 days. Right, so can you see that the resistances that he has just for simple...
This little dog almost looked like he's working this horse. I don't know whose dog it is. I'm assuming it's Parelli. I guess they're on Parelli's ranch. I don't know. But this dog is like seriously like, I'll make him move, Dad. You ready?
requests. Were you ever in the military?
No, I wasn't. Okay.
You've seen movies, yes, though, where yes. people...
Look, he's grabbing the freaking buckle again! Are you kidding me? The horse's ears are back. He doesn't feel comfortable. The horse doesn't want to be in here. The horse is still giving resistance. If you've got to pull your horse in to get him to come to you, you're probably not doing something right.
We'll go in the military and they go to boot camp. Yep. And they just ask, they just say, dig this ditch.
Change the behavior. Yep.
Just simple obedience.
Simple obedience, right.
Okay? And it has nothing to do with nothing. It just has to do with obedience. So that's what we're doing right now, okay? Now we're going to back him up a little bit. So put your hands on his nose because you're close.
Right.
Can't wiggle that rope up close. And I'll tap him here because we're up close. It's like another horse would kick him. Ah, no. Don't let him turn. There. Now wiggle the rope at him. Wiggle the rope at him. Wiggle the rope. No, don't let him turn. Don't let him turn. Don't let him turn. So hold, 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 hold there like that. So, okay, easy. Now just start wiggling the rope a little bit. You see, in order to get him to go backwards, he's got to stay perpendicular.
Right.
Okay, so in order to, what we've got to do is we've got to make it easy for him by keeping him looking at us. Okay, so if I try to back him up with this, now I've got to get his hindquarters away to get him to look at us again. There, sit. Now sit. And what you've got to be able to do is steer his nose this way.
This way.
Yeah, just but softly. Don't jerk it down. Just softly. That's good. That's good. Leave it alone.
Okay, that was a good correction. The guy doesn't have any feel or timing. Watch yeah, this tight rope.
Don't jerk it down. Just softly. That's good. That's good.
Look, see how he held that? And Parelli corrected him quick because he was putting so much pressure. He was teaching the horse, I got pressure here. I must want to do something. He was going to make the horse move. That's why Parelli got on him quickly. The guy didn't even realize that I was putting so much pressure, I was going to make the horse blow up. You can see that he's pulling. He told him to go easy. He's got that tight tension. The horse is like, oh, shit, I can't release this pressure.
Awfully, that's good. That's good. Leave it alone.
Parelli immediately grabbed it and release. He didn't say the term release, but he wanted to make sure the horse didn't get pressure. If the right answer is to stay and face us, stop giving him pressure. Don't pull and don't push.
So we're going to work together and back, teaching to back up. Teaching to back up. There, let it go. Let it slide. See, now, yeah, just, okay. So right. Now, just when he started to do what he wanted, you grabbed him and said,
right, yeah.
Okay. Oh, I'm the minister of no.
Right.
Quit it. Stop.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, whole idea, let it slide back. Is let it slide. Let it slide. So now all he has to do is face us when we want him to face us. And back up or come here. That's all. That's all he can do. Like a yo-yo. Come here and go back. You know, zoop, 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 zoop. All right, but
well, maybe this is a yo-yo game or something. I've heard a yo-yo game. There's something about it. He's got like 17 games or 10 games or so, I don't know. All I remember is a yo-yo because I see so many idiots doing it. I'm like, what the hell? Like, well, that's a yo-yo game.
That's what we want. Let's bring him in. Let the ropes on the ground. Let it slide. Bring it in. We're going to keep him perpendicular, 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 perpendicular. See, he's trying to turn. He's trying to. Now he's trying to go out and lunge around in a circle.
Right.
Okay. So we've got to say, no, don't do that.
Notice he switched to the heavy-ended handle and hit the horse in the head. He didn't hit him. He tapped him. But he wanted to give direction instead of the bag and cause a flight or jerking. He wanted more of a pinpoint. So he kind of switches.
Perpendicular, 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 perpendicular.
See? As soon as he figured out the whip wasn't working,
he's trying to turn.
He went to more direct pressure, like a spur or a jab or a stick or something to impress on a horse, stop going that way.
Now he's trying to go out and lunge around in a circle.
Right.
Okay. So we've got to say, no, don't.
So he tapped him. Nice top. He got good feel. He didn't hurt the horse. He could have if the horse would have got aggressive, but he didn't. So I'm okay with that.
Do that. Now bring his nose back. Bring his nose back. Good. Rub him.
See, when he said love him, he reached up
don't
so damn quick
bring
he scared
his nose
the
back.
Horse.
Bring his nose back.
Watch this reach.
Good. Rub him.
Love him. Rah, let me reach out. Predator. Horse is like, dude, you guys have been hitting me with the damn buckle. You've been yanking and pulling and confusing the shit out of me. Why the hell would I trust your hand? See, somebody who doesn't know would be like, this horse is spooky, man. Why does he lift his hand? That's crazy. That horse should... The horse is being reasonable to me. You make a quick jerky move right in my face area, and I'm going to jerk away.
A beam. There it goes. Soft. Relax. See him thinking? Look at his tail swishing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, now his tail swishing as he's thinking. Holy shit. That's a new one. See him thinking? His tail is swishing. His tail is swishing because he's irritated. He's frustrated. He's confused. He doesn't know what to expect.
He's going, all right, who changed the deal? He liked the rules the way they were before.
He did, yeah.
They were all in his favor.
They were his rules.
They're exactly. So all I'm asking you to do is to set some boundaries. All right, so let's try it again. Let's ask him to back up. Push on his nose. Put your hand the other way. Turn it upside down. Back him up. Okay, now let the rope slide. You guide his nose. I'll help back here a little bit. That's it. That's it. There, let it.
So this horse is getting double pressure now. He's getting shaking and bitting, and now he's got the flag coming up at him.
That's it. Just keep his nose that way. Keep his nose over that way.
And he's hitting him with a whip. Holy shit.
That's it. That's...
So he's getting pressure with the bag in the front, the rope shaking, and he's got the whip. Watch the whip in his right hand.
That's it. There. That's it. Just keep his nose that way. Keep his nose over that way. Keep his nose that way.
Jesus Christ. If you need this many hands to get a horse to back up, are you freaking kidding me?
Nose. There we go. Let it slide now. Let it slide. Now let it slide. All we have to do is keep him perpendicular. Keep his nose. Keep his nose. And the reason I want you to do this is that you, when you ride him, you have to control where his nose is.
Who thinks the horse is learning to back up? Who thinks the horse knows when he shakes the rope or hits me with the rope or the bag or the end of the hip hop? Who thinks the horse is like, oh, okay, I get it. I'm licking my lips. I got it. That must mean backup. Look, if it's not working, don't keep doing the same thing. It will eventually work because the horse will figure out that, you know what? I'll just give up. I'm getting, and that I don't like, you know, that beating to submission training type or irritating to submission.
Where is nose? All the time.
All the time. Let it slide. Let it slide. Let it slide. Let it slide back. There. Let it slide. Let it slide. Now wiggle the rope softly and get it to go back. Remember your wrist first. Now your elbow. Now your elbow. I'm just blocking him here a little bit because he's got to learn to quit pushing through pressure. That's good enough. That's good enough. So now let's ask.
This guy just kept pressuring, even though he didn't want a response. So the horse learned here
to learn.
Even when I back up and stand still, I still don't know what the right answer is because my stupid owner that loves me and wants to train me that doesn't know shit about horses is still shaking and causing me to do one of two things. So what's the horse learning here? Sometimes I ignore the shaking. Sometimes I try to pay attention. The horse is confused. He doesn't know. I don't even know. I'm watching. And I can't figure it out.
To quit pushing through pressure. That's good enough. That's good enough. So now let's ask him to go here again. Away from it. Away. Away. Go on. Go that way. 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 There we go. Hang on. There. See how much leverage you got?
Yeah. All
right. I mean, that's a...
Now, see, I don't think that horse is doing that on purpose. The horse just get confused. When he goes out there, he wants to go to his right side. I think he'd rather turn to the right. And so when he runs over there, he just naturally goes to that right turn and that side. I don't think it's malicious or mean whatsoever. And I'm not sure I would be fighting this and make it. Remember, when you make something a big deal, it becomes a big deal. If that's where he's comfortable going, then flip the rope over his head and let him spin that way. Hell, if he could spin that way, he might turn around and face you and give you what you want. But the structure, no, hang on, don't let him. Gotta make him go the way I want.
There. See how much leverage you got?
Yeah.
All right.
Gee, the horse isn't getting pressure. Okay, let's see. The horse isn't getting pressure. Who thinks he's gonna lick his lips?
I mean, that's a big one. Let's watch. Don't let him step over the rope. Just manage it a little bit. There you go. Hang on now. Get your power position. Just hold. Just hold. Just hold on. Very good. Okay, now I'm going to ask him here to go over.
Tail's very active.
That way again. Now I'm asking him to get parallel and go for it. Now hold on. Get your rope like I told you. Get it in your strength position. Very good. And pretty soon he's going to get parallel when we want and perpendicular when we want. And he's going to go forward in that circle. All right. Hang on. Now it's not a pullback. Mm-hmm. It's just a hold.
Just hold.
Hold.
Yeah.
And get that slack out of there. Okay? Now, because you can lean against that. But when you got a big old thing in here, broom, it's pulling,
yeah.
Yeah, you're gonna get out of whack there. Okay, now. Front end move over. Come on, Tobe. Over there, buddy. Over there. He says, no, I'm gonna run through the pressure.
So he's really attacking his eye. The horse is raising his head to get away from his eye so he can see. And Parelli is intentionally going after the eye because he wants the most pressure he can get without beating or doing it. And that bag to the eye is going to force him to say, shit, I can't see. I've got to move away so I can see. So that's not unintentional. Is it good? I'm not a fan of it. I don't like shaking a plastic bag by my horse's eye. Could it cut the eye? Could it irritate the eye? Could I accidentally slap in the eye? Yeah. I don't necessarily think that's a good thing, but if you've got a very stubborn horse that you can't get results any other way, maybe that'll work.
Here. Attaboy, now go. Go for your life.
Little protest kick. Notice Parelli didn't make maybe he is going to make a big deal. I haven't given him a chance, but to me, that's a little protest kick. I'm getting a lot of pressure. I'm trying to get away. I'm going to go ahead and kick up when I leave.
All right, now hang for that power position. There we go.
And Parelli ignored it, kind of like I would do. I don't really give a shit about that.
That's good.
Now, there'll be some people out there, he tried to kick you, and that's disrespectful, and you should never let a horse do that. You need to run him and chase him and make him. You need to really get on him. To me, it's not a big deal. Ignore it.
Now, reel him in. Let's bring him forward. So in order for you to get any control, you've got to have communication. And you've got to test some things. You ever fly an airplane?
No.
You've flown in one?
Yes.
Well, you better hope that the pilot checks all this kind of stuff out before he takes off.
Yep.
We call this pre-flight checks. So in other words, you getting on this horse without doing some of these things is like just getting in an airplane and just, hey, well, let's just see if it flies. Let's get up there and see what happens. All right? Because now you've got more of an idea, and I've got more of an idea, what it's going to take to bend his neck around to get him under control. All right.
The horse, it tail's active, and I thought I saw a big fly out there on him. When I see a horse, just like I don't like a human confused and talking to two people and confusing the horse, when I want the horse to pay attention to me, I don't want him fighting flies. It's an extra irritant to aggravate the horse. If you're working or shoeing or doing something with a horse and the horse is reacting to the flies, then you need to get some fly spray on him so he can pay attention to you and not have to defend himself against the flies. He's not being mean. The flies are biting him and they're irritating him. So he has to concentrate on getting the flies off him, which means he's not concentrating on the lesson. So put some freaking fly spray on your horse, people.
All right, you ready? Let's back him up. Push on his nose softly. All right, there we go. Now wiggle the rope a little bit.
So you can see the flies, and you see his shaking the flies off him a lot. The flies are bad out there. I'd be like, don't freaking bring me a horse to work with, and I got to fight the flies.
That's it. Don't let him turn. And stand still, and don't let him turn. Stand still. Don't go over there. Stand still. Hey, where are you going, Tope? Where are you going? And then when he goes to go backwards, let it slide. So he's trying to go back.
Yeah.
Now wiggle it a little bit and let it slide. So we've got to get him. You came here and you said he wouldn't go around in a circle. Now he only wants to go in a circle.
Right.
Let it slide. Keep going. Come on. Get him all the way back. So he's got to know the difference. All right. Good. Keep working. There, stop. Let it slide. Now let him have the rope. Let him have it. There. See, that's the reward. The reward is loose reins.
Pressure's off. Yeah.
Loose reins. The reward is.
So the guy said it like he knows. Oh, yeah. Pressure off. See, the guy can say it, and he probably read it, but he has no idea how to apply it. I mean, he hasn't done one thing pressure and release right. But he just said, oh yeah, release the pressure. Take it away. So he's read it. He may think he understands it, but he doesn't have a clue when it comes to application.
Loose rope. Okay, this is a rein.
Yep.
It's just happened to have one of them, right? If you had two of them, you could put one on each side, drive him around like a plow horse, right? That's just a rein. All right. Now we're going to go perpendicular. I mean, we're perpendicular. We're going to go parallel now. Ask him to go over here. Go on. Now I'm asking you to turn. Stay still. You stay in your power position. Power position. Now you got kind of the wrong one, right?
Okay.
You know what I mean? For that direction.
Yep, that direction.
Now if he's going to go that way, you better get ready for the other one because I'm switching on you.
He's told this guy 14 times, don't have slack between the two hands because you get a pop and you lose power. See, people can't even control their hands. They can't do one thing that you tell them, and suddenly they want a lesson with a horse and they want you to fix all the problems. He has told him several times not to put slack in between his freaking hands, and this guy hasn't got it.
Hang on. There you go. See
slack.
How much leverage you got?
Yep.
Isn't that kind of cool? Tell me what you're learning so far. What's going through your mind?
Slack.
Total control, okay? Where he will get out of my space. He will lunge. He'll go around in a circle.
Slack.
With actually out any pressure.
Pass it around your back now. Now stand here and just talk to me. Oh, wait, now. Okay, now.
Now, I think the horse might have tried to intimidate him and backing up on that one. That looked like the horse might have been like, you know,
you're
what? I'm tired of running.
I'm
trying to get my button here. And
oh, wait, now.
Back in there. Okay. And then as soon as he saw this bag out of the corner of his eye, he went, oh, shit, I don't want nothing to do with that. Watch his horse's reaction when Parelli just lifts the bag off the ground.
Pass it.
Pretty
pass
clear.
On your back now. Now
watch the bag.
Oh, wait, now.
Boom.
Okay, now. Pass it around your back. Stand still. Look at me. Just look at me and pass it around.
Okay.
Here, you can pass me the rope. Watch. All right, then I'll pass you the rope. See what I mean? We don't need to do anything. Just pass it around.
Just pass it around and he'll.
Well, and if he doesn't, then we'll do something. Now turn and I'll bring him in. That's good that he does it because that way if you ever fell off, he'd run back to you.
Okay.
So you're teaching him, yes, turn, face, and come back.
Come back in. Okay.
Yeah. See, we're lunging. That's what I don't like, that word lunging. That teaches people to teach their horse to escape. Run away in a circle, and if I drop the rope, you go right back to the shorthand, no slack.
No, he's ready to
happen.
Start.
That's what would happen. But when we keep rewarding him for coming back, okay?
Yep.
Okay, now, let's see if we can get him to go. That's good. Now, slowly press on his nose. There we go. Back him up. There we go. See how quickly he learns? Wiggle. Wiggle. Isn't that kind of cool?
Yeah.
Okay, that's enough. So now we're just getting the very basics of things. First thing I did was, he ain't afraid of this stuff.
No.
He just is conditional, right? Now let him have the whole rope because I'm going to ask him to get parallel again. Parallel, move the front over, let it slide, let the rope slide. Move over, Toby, over there. Stay there.
Now, to me, the horse is showing more resistance now than when they started. And because I think the horse is getting frustrated, he's not learning the right answer. He's not learning how to get release. So he's like, screw it. I'm going to stop trying. I'll just fight you. I don't like the progress right here.
Go, Toby, go. Hang on. All right. Go, Toby, go. Move your front, and go. He doesn't like it.
He's like, screw you, Parelli. Yep, take these 2 feet, suck on it. Oh, shit, I'm at 34 minutes. All right, I think we're at 4, part 5.